فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. سورة المطففين، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويل للمطففين الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون ليوم عظيم يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين كلا إن كتاب الفجار لفي سجين وما أدراك ما سجين كتاب مرقوم ويل يومئذ للمكذبين الذين يكذبون بيوم الدين وما يكذب به إلا كل معتد أثيم إذا تتلى عليه آياتنا قال أساطير الأولين كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون كلا إنهم عن ربهم يومئذ لمحجوبون ثم إنهم لصالو الجحيم ثم يقال هذا الذي كنتم به تكذبون كلا إن كتاب الفجار لفي سجين كلا إن كتاب الأبرار لفي عليين وما أدراك ما عليون كتاب مرقوم يشهده المقربون إن الأبرار لفي نعيم على الأرائك ينظرون تعرف في وجوههم نضرة النعيم يسقون من رحيق مختوم ختامه مسك وفي ذلك فليتنافس المتنافسون ومزاجه من تسنيم عينا يشرب بها المقربون إن الذين أجرموا كانوا من الذين آمنوا يضحكون وإذا مروا بهم يتغامزون وإذا انقلبوا إلى أهلهم انقلبوا فكهين وإذا رأوهم قالوا إن هؤلاء لضالون وما أرسلوا
عليهم حافظين فاليوم الذين آمنوا من الكفار يضحكون على الأرائك ينظرون هل ثوب الكفار ما كانوا يفعلون
سورة المطففين. The scholars, they differed whether سورة المطففين is a Meccan surah or a Medinian surah. There's a khilaf amongst the mufassirin. They differ. And the strongest of the two opinions is that Surah Al-Mutaffifin is a Medinian surah. And the reason why that is the strongest of the two opinions is because the hadith which Ibn Abbas narrated, he said, لَمَّا قَدِمَ نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الْمَدِينَةِ When the Prophet Nabiullahi Muhammad came to the city of Medina, كَانُوا مِنْ أَخْبَثِ النَّاسِ كَيْلًا That the people of Medina were the filthiest of people when it came to the scaling and the measuring. فَأَنْزَلُ اللَّهُ Allah then sent down the surah. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ Woe to those who give less in their measuring and their scaling. فَحَسَّنُوا كَيْلَهُمْ And when this surah came down, they perfected their measuring and their scaling. This hadith Al-Imam Hafidh ibn Hajar, he authenticated in his Kitab Fath al-Bari, which is a sharh of Sahih al-Bukhari. Al-Imam al-Hakim in his Kitab al-Mustadrak, and also Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, his ta'liq on the Mustadrak of Al-Imam Abu Abdullah al-Hakim ibn Isaburi. So this surah is a Madanian surah according to the strongest of the two opinions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ Woe to those who give less than due. When they come to the scaling and they are measuring, what they do is they give less to those whose rights it is to give them a particular amount. They choose to give the less. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains it after that he says, الَّذِينَ they are the ones إِذَا اكْتَالُوا when they measure. عَلَى النَّاسِ when they measure for themselves يَسْتَوْفُونَ they give themselves their fair right. They give themselves justice. They make sure that they get their rights. وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ but when they are measuring for the other people and it's their the other people's rights أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ if after measuring for the other people or they are weighing it for the other people. يُخْسِرُونَ They cause less, they give less to the others. And this goes against the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, which is, لَا يُؤْمِنُ أَحَدُكُمْ that one of you is not a true believer. حَتَّى يُحِبَّ لِأَخِيهِ until he loves for his brother, what he loves for himself. And so what they've chosen to do is that they scale for themselves and they measure for themselves, they make sure they take their rights. But when they're doing it for others, they've got double standards. And the Arabs, they made a statement out of that. They said, Al-Kaylu bi-mikyalain, wal-waznu bi-mizanain. That they have two scalings. One scale for themselves, and they take their rights in that way. And they've got another scaling machine for other people. So when they're scaling for other people, they scale in another way. This is something that Ummah Muhammad were not the first to come with. It was present and it was specifically found in the people of Nabiullah Shu'aib. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he states in the Quran, he says, وَإِلَى مَدْيَنَ أَخَاهُمْ شُعَيْبًا The people of Madian, their brother Nabiullah Shu'aib, he came to them and he said to them, قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهَ O my people, worship Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala and single him in worship. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهَ Worship Allah alone. Now what you have to understand is, Shu'aib before he calls them to anything else, what is it that he starts with? عِبَادَةُ wahda. They've got other community problems, communal problems, they've got social problems. He starts with the Tawheed.
And this is something that we all need to take on board. He says to them, قَالَ my people, يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرُهُ. You have no ilah besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَدْ جَاءَتْكُمْ. It has come to you. بَيِّنَةٌ. A clear-cut evidence has come to you from your Lord. مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. And then he goes on to saying, فَأَوْفُ الْكَيْلَ وَالْمِيزَانَ. Be just and upright and fair in regards to the measuring for people and the weighing that you do for others. Be fair and just. وَلَا تَبْخَسُ النَّاسِ. Don't be stingy in the people's rights. Don't cause loss for others. وَلَا تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ بَعْدَ إِصْلَاحِهَا. Do not bring corruption to this earth after it's been perfected and good has come. So Nabi Shu'aib started with Tawheed. He reminded them of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's worship, and then he spoke to them about the problem that they have. But when a person scales, sometimes, or they weigh, or even sometimes when you're giving people their rights, it may happen after you fearing Allah, after putting all the effort in, you might sometimes feel that you've one grain of rice might go towards you. It could happen. So that's why Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَوْفُ الْكَيْلَ وَالْمِيزَانَ. Be upright and just in the measuring and the weighing for others. لَا نُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا وُسْعَهَا. We do not burden a soul more than what it can carry. Because that's not what you can control, can you? The grain that comes to you, one grain of rice, the scaling machine won't tell. You won't be able to realize. So if it goes on your side or if it goes on their side, Allah says to you, لَا نُكَلِّفُ نَفْسًا. We do not burden a soul more than that which it can carry. Then that's not your problem. But once you've come with piety and uprightness, and you are just and you're giving the people their rights, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to burden you for what you're trying your best. Allah says, الَّذِينَ those, إِذَا اكْتَالُوا. When they measure for people. So the word, إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ. When they are measuring for themselves, they take their due rights. Not a penny goes away from them. They know their maths properly then. They know their scaling properly. But when it comes to other people's rights, وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ. But when they are measuring for others and they are doing it for others, كَالُو. It means to measure. أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ. Means weighing. يُخْسِرُونَ. What they do is they bring loss to the people. They bring loss to the people. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, أَلَا يَظُنُّ. Do they not think? The word يَظُنُّ in the Quran, it sometimes comes as the meaning of certainty, yaqeen. It's used, the word dhan, sometimes in the Quran, it is used as what? As certainty. And there's two tariqa, two paths in which we can take this verse. We can leave the word dhan at its apparent meaning and not take it towards certainty. We can say here, dhan means assumption and to think. So Allah is saying to them, أَلَا يَظُنُّ. Do they not think? أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ. Do they not think that they will be resurrected and they will be accounted for everything which they have done? Are they not aware that Allah is going to question them from this measuring and this scaling which they are doing and this weighing? Do they not think? So if we leave it at thinking, then it would mean if you think is great, is lesser than if you have certainty, it's more of a reason for you to what? To be fearful of Allah. Some of the mufassirin, they say, it means, do they not know and have certainty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to resurrect them? Because the Quran uses the word dhan. Inni dhanantu anni mulaqin hisabiyah. Inni dhanantu here means, I am certain. Also Allah says in another place, الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُوا رَبِّهِمْ. الَّذِينَ يَظُنُّونَ means here, those who are certain that they're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it comes in those two meanings. أَلَا يَظُنُّ. Are they not certain? أُولَٰئِكَ those. Who is the أُولَٰئِكَ going back to? Those who are being unjust in their weighing and their scaling and their measuring. أَنَّهُمْ. That they are مَبْعُوثُونَ. That they're going to be resurrected for a tremendous day. لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. For a tremendous day. The day which they're going to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not a light day. It's not a day where you would take it lightly. It's a tremendous, it's a great day. And something Allah has referred to as azim, then it's not for you to take it very lightly. The creator of the heavens and the earth has referred to this day as what? لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. It's a tremendous day. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He goes into explaining for us what that day is. What is that day? What is that tremendous day? It's the day يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. It is the day that all mankind are going to stand before their Lord, the Lord of the entire worlds, the heaven and the earth, all galaxies and all universes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the Lord of all of that. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ. It is the day in which all mankind are going to stand, يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. They are going to stand before the Lord of the worlds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in more than one hadith, has given us an understanding of that day which we're going to all stand in front of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in a hadith that al-Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim, and other than them two, other than Bukhari and Muslim, narrated in hadithi Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that the Prophet said, when he recited the verse, يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, the Prophet recited this verse, and then he said, حَتَّى يَغِيبَ أَحَدُهُمْ, until the person is enveloped, أَحَدُهُمْ فِي رَشْحِهِ إِلَىٰ أَنصَافِ أُذُنِهِ, until the person is enveloped in their sweat. That day, when the people stand in front of Allah, the people are going to start to sweat, and their sweat starts coming from their forehead. And then the person's sweat becomes so much that it fills the earth. It fills where they are standing on. And it goes up, and it goes up, and it fills up to their ears. The Prophet said this, alayhi salatu wasalam, حَتَّى يَغِيبَ أَحَدُهُمْ, that until one of us, the people who are standing in front of Allah that day, they're going to be enveloped in the sweat up to the middle of their ear. فِي رَشْعِهِ إِلَىٰ أَنصَافِ أُذُنِهِ. الإمام البخاري المسلم also narrated in the Sahih من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما, the standing that was going to take place the day of judgment. The Prophet stood up one day, قام فينا رسول الله, he said, Abdullah ibn Abbas, خطيبا بموعظة, the Prophet stood up and he gave us a sermon, a reminder. فقال, the Prophet said, يا أيها الناس, O people, إنكم تحشرون إلى الله, you will all be gathered in front of Allah. You will all be assembled in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before Him, إلى الله, حُفَاتًا, you will be barefooted. عُرَاتًا, you will also be naked. غُرْلًا, you will be uncircumcised. كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُ وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. You will be brought back, Allah says, just like you left Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like the first time you were created. كَمَا بَدَأْنَا, as we started you, we'll bring you back to the starting point again. كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُ, we'll bring you back. Allah then says, وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا, this is a promise of us. إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ, we are ones who are going to do that. The Prophet recited that verse. And then the Prophet said, أَلَا, O people, وَإِنَّ أَوَّلَ الْخَلَائِقِ, the first of the creation, يُكْسَى يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, the first of the creation who is going to be given clothing is Ibrahim عليه السلام. Everybody that day, as I said, as the narration mentioned, everyone that day is naked, barefooted, uncircumcised. Your body comes back to its original form. Allah says, I'm going to do that, I promise you. I promise you that will happen. That He will bring you back to your original state. And then the Prophet said that the first person who would be given clothes, who would be allowed to wear clothes, is Ibrahim. Nabiullah Ibrahim would be the first person to be given clothes. And then the Prophet said, أَلَا وَإِنَّهُ سَيُجَاءُ بِرِجَالٍ. Then the Prophet said, a group of men would be brought. مِنْ أُمَّتِي, from my ummah would be brought. فَيُؤْخَذُ بِهِمْ ذَاتَ الشِّمَالِ, they would be taken towards the left direction. فَأَقُولُ, I then say, يَا رَبِّ, my Lord, أَصْحَابِ, these are my companions, my followers. These are my followers. فَيُقَالُ It would then be said to me, إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحْدَثُ بَعْدَكَ Muhammad, صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُ عَلَيْهِ You are unaware of what these people introduced after you departed from them. The ummah changed. They evolved. They started to make practices into the religion. That's not part of it. Innovation started to creep in. They made a religion something that wasn't what you came with. After Allah sent down the ayah, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا After Allah completed His religion, they came and they added onto the religion. إِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي مَا أَحَدَثُ بَعْدَكَ Muhammad, you're unaware of and you don't know what these people have introduced into the religion after you. فَأَقُولُ I then say, كَمَا قَالَ عَبْدُ الصَّالِحِ I say, as the righteous slave of Allah said. Who is he referring to? Isa ibn Maryam. I'm saying what he said, which is, وَكُنْتُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا مَا دُمْتُ فِيهِمْ I was, when I was with them, I was a witness over them. I was observing them. فَلَمَّا تَوَفَّيْتَنِي When you took me and I left, كُنْتَ أَنْتَ الرَّقِيبَ عَلَيْهِمْ When you took me and I died, you were the one who's looking over them, oh Allah. وَأَنْتَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ شَهِيدٍ Oh Allah, you are one who witnesses and sees everything that's taking place. إِنْ تُعَذِّبْهُمْ Oh Allah, if you choose to punish them, فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكَ Then they are your slaves. وَإِنْ تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ And if you choose to forgive them, فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ Then you are Aziz, أي الْغَالِبُ فِي أَمْرِهِ Aziz means the one who what he wants will happen and no one can stop it. Al-Hakim, one who is wise. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَيُقَالُ لِي It would then be said to me, إِنَّهُمْ لَمْ يَزَالُوا These people have not except remain. The word لَمْ is نَفِي. يَزَال مَعْنَ النَّفِي. In قَاعِدَ النَّحْوَ is what? نَفِيُ نَفِيُ إِثْبَات. Negation, negation shows affirmation, affirmation. لَمْ يَزَالُوا They did not remain. These people. So we say they remained. مُرْتَدِّينَ Those who apostated ala a'qabihim on their heels منذ فارقتهم when you departed from them, Muhammad. So this is the standing that's going to take place the day of judgment. How are we going to stand in front of Allah? Hufatan, uratan, gurran. We're going to stand in front of Allah naked, barefooted, and uncircumcised. Also, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated in their Sahih min Hadith Anas ibn Malikim. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man said to him, Ya Nabi Allah, O Prophet of Allah, كيف يحشر الكافر على وجهه? A man came to the Prophet and he said to him, O Muhammad, how is Allah going to resurrect the disbelievers on their faces? Because they're going to be resurrected, dragged on their faces. How is Allah going to do that? And then the Prophet said to him, أليس الذي أمشاه على الرجلين Is he not the one who made them walk on their two feet? في الدنيا in this world, is he not قادرا, is he not able على أن يمشيه that he would make him walk على وجه يوم القيامة to walk on his face the day of judgment? Is he not able to make them do that? The one who made them walk on this, their two feet now on this earth is able to make them walk on their face the day of judgment. So this is what's going to happen the Day of Judgment. I'm going to, inshallah ta'ala, go through a very lengthy hadith, inshallah ta'ala, that Al-Imam Al-Bukhari and Muslim both narrated. This hadith is the famous hadith of Abu Sa'id Al-Khudri. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to the companions, the Prophet was sitting with his companions one day. قُلْنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ We said, O Messenger of Allah, هَلْ نَرَى رَبَّنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ The companions, they said, O Messenger of Allah, are we going to see Allah the Day of Judgment? Look how the companions, what they are desiring, what they want, what they're wishing for. هَلْ نَرَى رَبَّنَا Are we going to see our Lord the Day of Judgment? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to them, هَلْ تُضَارُونَ فِي رُؤْيَةِ الشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ إِلَىٰ كَانَتْ صَحْوَةِ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Do you have any difficulties? Do you have any difficulties? في رؤية الشمس in seeing the sun والقمر and the moon إذا كانت صحوا when the sky is clear. Do you have any problem? When the sky is clear, there's no clouds, and the sun is there. Do you have any trouble seeing the sun? No. The same is when it's not cloudy, and the sky is clear, and the moon is out. Do you have any problem seeing the moon? The answer is no. قُلْنَا لَا. We said no. He said, فَإِنَّكُمْ لَا تُضَارُونَ فِي رُؤْيَةِ رَبِّكُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ. Just the same way you don't have no difficulties in seeing the sun and the moon when the sky is clear, like that, you guys will see your Lord with no difficulties. إِلَّا كَمَا تُضَارُونَ فِي رُؤْيَتِهِمَا. Then the Prophet told him a story. He said of how we're going to see Allah the Day of Judgment and how the standing, يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. That standing in front of Allah, how is going to take place. This hadith is the most lengthiest and it's the longest, and this is what we're all going to have, only going to have time to do, inshaAllah ta'ala. So pay attention to this hadith. There's a lot of benefits in it, and there's a lot of gems in it. The Prophet said, Yunadi munadin, a caller will call out. A caller will call out, and he will say, ليذهب كل قوم إلى ما كانوا يعبدون. Every nation go towards what you used to worship. Every nation go towards what you used to worship. فيذهب أصحاب الصليب. The ones who worship the cross, they will go مع صليبهم. They'll go to their cross. وأصحاب الأوثان. The idol worshippers. مع أوثانهم. They will go towards their idol worshipping and what they worshipped. وأصحاب كل آلهة. Every individual, their God that they worship, they go towards it. حتى يبقى من كان يعبد الله. Until there remains those who used to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. من بر أو فاجر. Whether it be the obedient ones that worshipped Allah or the mischievous ones who are up to no good. Both parties, but they believed they worshipped Allah. They did not associate partners with Allah. Them, they remain. Everyone else goes. Everyone else goes towards what they worshipped. The Christians, they go to their God and what they worshipped. And the cross that they worshipped. Everyone goes where they want. وَغَبَرَاتُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. And some of the people of the scripture. ثُمَّ يُؤْتَى بِجَهَنَّمْ. Then Jahannam will be brought. تُعْرَضُ كَأَنَّهَا سَرَابٌ. It will be presented like it's a mirage. فَيُقَالُ لِلْيَهُودِ. The Jahannam looks like a mirage. And so the Yahud, the Jews, they say, it will be said to them, مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ. What is it that you guys used to worship? قَالُوا. They will say, كُنَّا نَعْبُدُ عُزَيْرَ بْنُ اللَّهِ. We used to worship Uzair, the son of Allah. فَيُقَالُ. It will be then said to them, كَذَبْتُمْ. You guys have lied. لَمْ يَكُلْ لِلَّهِ صَاحِبَةٌ وَلَا وَلَدٌ. Allah did not have a wife and a spouse, nor did he have any children. فَمَا تُرِيدُونَ. You guys are liars there. What do you want? Because they can see Jahannam, the Nar, and it seems to them mirage. Mirage, what does it look like? Water. So they think what's there is water. So they say, نُرِيدُ أَن تَسْقِيَنَا. We want you to give us water to drink. فَيُقَالُ. It will be then said to them, إِشْرَبُ. Go to the mirage and drink from it then. فَيَتَسَاقَطُونَ فِي جَهَنَّمْ. And when they go towards it, they drop into hellfire. ثُمَّ يُقَالُ لِلنَّصَارَى. And then it will be said to the Christians, مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ. What is it that you guys used to worship? فَيَقُولُونَ. They say, كنا نعبد المسيح ابن الله. We used to worship Masih, the son of God. فَيُقَالُ. It would be said to them, كَذَبْتُمْ. You guys have lied. Masih is not the son of Allah. كَذَبْتُمْ. لَمْ يَكُلْ لِلَّهِ صَاحِبَةٌ. Allah did not have a spouse and a wife. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَا وَلَدْ. Allah did not have a child and a son. فَمَا تُرِيدُونَ. What is it that you guys want? فَيَقُولُونَ. They would say, because they see the mirage, Jahannam seems to them like water. They say, نُرِيدُ أَن تَسْقِيَنَا. We want you to give us water to drink. They're thirsty, people are sweating. They see the mirage, they think it's water. And then it will be said to them, إِشْرَبُوا. Go and drink from it. They'll go towards it, thinking it's water. فَيَتَسَاقَطُونَ. Then they drop into the hellfire. حَتَّى يَبْقَى مَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ. Then the believers are still standing there. They have not moved. The ones who used to worship Allah, they are still standing there. مِنْ بَرٍّ أَوْ فَاجِرٍ. The obedient ones and the mischievous ones are still standing there. They haven't moved from their position. فَيُقَالُ لَهُمْ. It will be said to them, مَا يَحْبِسُكُمْ. What is it that's imprisoning you guys? Why are you guys standing here? Why haven't you moved from your positions? وَقَدْ ذَهَبَ النَّاسِ. The people who left. The Christians, they went. The Jews, they went. Why are you guys still standing here? فَيَقُولُونَ. They say. Their response is, فَارَقْنَاهُمْ. يَرْحَمُكَ اللَّهُ. We departed from the disbelievers, the Christians and the Jews. وَنَحْنُ أَحْوَجُ مِنَّا إِلَيْهِ يَوْمَئِذٍ. The day of the dunya when we were there, when we most needed them, we left them for our religion and we turned away from them and we chose the religion of Allah. Today that we don't need them, we're not going to go with them. And they say, نعم. وَإِنَّا سَمِعْنَا. Also, we heard a caller that called out and that said, لِيَلْحَقَ كُلُّ قَوْمٍ مِمَّا كَانُوا يَعْبُدُونَ. That everybody go towards who you worshipped. وَإِنَّمَا نَنْتَظِرُ رَبَّنَا. But we're waiting for our Lord Allah. Because remember the beginning, the Munadi said, everyone go towards what you were worshipping. We're upon that. We're just waiting for our Lord. فَيَأْتِيهِمُ الْجَبَّارِ. Allah comes to them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. في صورة, in a form that they don't recognize, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah previously came to them. This time they don't recognize him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says to them, أنا ربكم. I am your Lord. فيقولون. They say to them, أنت ربنا. You're our Lord. فلا يكلمه. Allah does not speak to them. Except that messengers and the prophets are the permitted ones to talk. فيقول. He says, هل بينكم وبينه آية تعرفونه. Is there a sign that you would know your Lord if you saw him? And they say, فيقولون. The believers, they say, الساق. Allah's shin. Allah's shin. And then فيكشف عن ساقه. Allah unveils his shin. فيسجد له كل مؤمن. Every believer will fall into prostration. يوم يكشف عن ساق ويدعون إلى السجود. The day where the believers will fall into prostration. ويبقى من كان يعب من كان يسجد لله ريان. Every believer who used to prostrate to Allah based on sincerity will fall into prostration the minute Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unveils his shin. The ones who used to show off and the ones who were doing it out of sum'atan so they can gain reputation from the people, فيذهبوا كيما. Their backs become stiff and rigid. They can't move. They can't go down. Allah makes it tabaqan wahidan, like a wooden, stiff, rigid. They can't move and go down. ثم يؤتى بالجسر. Then what is brought to them is the bridge. It's placed right in front of them. فيجعل بين ظهري الجهنم. The bridge is thrown on top of Jahannam. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَى رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقَضِيًّا. That Jahannam, everybody and even the believers are going to go through it. Jahannam, everyone's going to go through it. Meaning the bridge that goes over Jahannam. The bridge is placed. Then the Sahabas, they said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَمَا الْجَسْرُ. What's this bridge that you're talking about, O Messenger of Allah? And the Prophet, he said, it's a slippery bridge, very slippery, on which there are clamps. This bridge, it has clamps, and it has hooks, and it has a thorny seed, very thin, that is also wide, and one side is narrow, and the other side is also narrow. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, this thorny seed, which this bridge is found in the people of Sa'dan. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the believers, they go over it in different levels, the believers. some of the believers will go over it like katarfi, like a wink. Another group will go like kalbarqi, like lightning, how they go over it fast. Another group will go over it like wind. And another group, kaajawid al-farasi, ama al-khayli, they will go over it as fast as a horse. Others will go over it like a camel. Fanajin musallam, a group of the believers and a group of people are going to be saved and prosperous, and they're going to make it through. Nothing's going to happen to them. Wanajin and others are going to go over it, but they are makhdushun, makdus. They are scratched and they fall down onto it. It cuts them up. And another group of them, they are unable to finish the bridge, so they are fully dragged from it. They are dragged. حَتَّى يَمُرَّ آخِرُهُمْ يُسْحَبُ سَحْبًا. Then the Prophet said, those believers, when they make it out of the bridge and they make it on the other side, they realize some of their brothers have fallen into the hellfire. Because on top of this bridge is, on beneath this bridge is what? Jahannam. Some of the believers have already fallen into it. So when they come out on the other side, they turn towards their Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet said that day the believers, the way that they call on to their Lord and they are consistent in begging. Look how beneficial the believers are for one another. They say, Rabbana, our Lord, ikhwanuna, our brothers, our Muslim brothers, alladhina kanu yusalluna ma'ana, those who used to pray with us, wa yasumuna ma'ana, they used to fast with us, wa ya'maluna ma'ana, they used to come with righteous deeds with us, they were with us in the khayr. Fayaqulu Allahu ta'ala, Allah says, idhabu, go. فَمَنْ وَجَدْتُمْ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ دِينَارٍ مِنْ إِيمَانٍ. Go. And anyone that you find in his heart is the amount of a dinar. A dinar is a golden currency that was used of iman in their hearts. Then what you need to do is take them out of the hellfire. Take them out of the hellfire. فَأَخْرِجُوهُ وَيُحَرِّمُ اللَّهُ صُوَرَهُمْ عَلَى النَّارِ. And Allah makes sure that He protects their forehead from the fire eating it, because they used to prostrate from these places. فَيَأْتُونَهُمْ, they come and they take them out of the hellfire. But the fire has burnt part of their body and it's eaten them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says to them, go back. Anybody you find in the hellfire whose iman is what? مِثْقَالَ نِصْفِ دِينَارٍ, half of a dinar, half of it. And they go and they take out whoever they recognize. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He goes and says, go back again. Anyone you find in the hellfire, فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ مِنْ إِيمَانٍ, a mustard seed, an atom weight of iman in their heart, take them out of the hellfire. And then they go and they take them out of the hellfire, whoever they recognize. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri said, فَإِن لَمْ تُصَدِّقُونِ, if you guys don't believe what I'm saying, فَقْرَأُوا, recite the verse, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَظْلِمُ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ, Allah does not oppress an atom weight of righteous deed that a person comes with. وَإِن تَكُ حَسَنًا, if the person has done good, Allah will multiply it for them and He will bring it for them. فَيَشْفَعُ النَّبِيُّونَ, the prophets will intercede. وَالْمَلَائِكَ, the angels will then intercede. وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ, and the believers will all intercede. فَيَقُولُ الْجَبَّارُ, Allah then says, شَفَعَ النَّبِيُّونَ وَشَفَعَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the prophets have interceded, the angels have interceded, the believers have interceded. Only one person's intercession remains. Who is it? My intercession, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And then what does Allah do? فَيَقْبِضُ قَبْضَهُ, Allah takes, He places a handful, He grabs a handful, subhanahu wa ta'ala, of people, and He takes them out of the hellfire. فَيَخْرُجُ أَقْوَامًا, a group of people come out, قَدْ امْتُحِشُوا, they've become ashes and they've got burnt. They become ashes and burnt. And then they get taken to a river that's at the entrance of Jannah, and they get dipped into this Jannah. this river, when they get dipped into this river is called the water of life, ma'ul hayat, ma'ul hayati. And then when they go in and they are placed inside it and they come out, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He takes them to Jannah. And when He takes them to Jannah, they have on their necks jewels and lu'lu' that they are wearing. And they are very unique from the people of Jannah. They are recognized. And the people of Jannah, they refer to them as Rutaqa'ur Rahman. The people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He emancipated with His grace and His mercy. That's what they get known for. So this hadith gives us an understanding of what is meant by يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. And this is the longest hadith in that regard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَوْمَ the day يَقُومُ النَّاسُ, that mankind will stand before the Lord of the worlds, لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْفُجَّارِ لَفِي سِجِّينَ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سِجِّينَ كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ. We'll stop there inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong and incorrect is from me, as shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.